Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Over the weekend, I was in my craft room making a lot of greeting cards. I have some possible craft shows coming up this summer, as well as a place that I create cards for locally. So I was trying to kind of fill up the supply a little bit. And as I was making cards, I was thinking that it might be helpful to do a video on some shortcuts that I use to make designing cards really easy. And I broke it down into four different tips. So I will go ahead and go over those with you. The first one is to use a sketch from other cards that you've made. So for instance, I would have a card that I really liked, and I would kind of look at it and decide, kind of sketch, do a sketch in my head of just the components of the card. And what I like to do, and I have a video that I can link below, I like to keep these sketches in my little card sketch recipe box. And these, I have a whole bunch of cards in here from previous cards that I've made where I just kind of draw a little sketch of the design of the card. And this way I can refer back to it whenever I want to, or if I need like a quick idea for a card, it's really helpful. So like I said, I'll link that below. And so the next step, or the next kind of tip I like to use when creating a card, is to create some albums in my phone of some favorite card designs. And what I'll do is kind of divide up. I have in my phone, I have two different albums. One is for craft show ideas for gift cards and tags. And then the other one is cards that I like to use for sketches. So what I usually do is take a screenshot of my cards on Instagram, and I just compile them all into this album, or divide them up according to whichever album I want to put them in. And this makes it a lot easier than having to scroll through all your photos in your phone to try to find your cards and everything like that. So that just, it's kind of an easy way to stay organized. And then I can just pull some ideas from there when I want to make a card. The next tip is just to make the same card. So basically that's what it is. It's kind of just don't reinvent the wheel. Basically, if you have a card you like, just go ahead and recreate it. One person that you give that birthday card to is not going to, may not know the other person who gets the same birthday card. So I think that's totally fine. If you're creating for craft shows or something like that, you want to keep in mind angel policy rules for certain stamp companies. Sometimes they have rules as to how many you can make with a stamp set, but they're usually pretty generous, so you can usually don't have a problem with that. But that's what I like to do sometimes, is just make multiples of one card. And then the last tip is to use up your scraps. And in a previous video, I had shown this card tutorial on how I used a piece of scrapbook paper that I really liked to create a card. And what I like to do too is keep a list of extras, which I've also talked about in other videos, just extra pieces of stamped cardstock, embossed cardstock, things that I didn't use for other projects. I'll keep those in a little box and then I'll just sift through them. This was one that I actually just did, a stencil that I didn't end up using. I'll just kind of sift through the container and grab some pieces to just throw together on a card. And a lot of times I like this technique because I sort of take all the thought out of it and I just kind of go with what I have to work with. And I find I get even more creative by doing that. So hopefully you'll be able to use these four tips that I use to help you in your card design and card making. So thanks so much for joining me today, and I'll see you in my next video.